This is Eddie, a travel trailer that I've built from the ground up. And if you haven't been watching, here's what you missed so far. So at the end of episode 9, I had the rubber roof membrane attached to the roof of the trailer. As you can see, it hung down and it needed to be trimmed off. I decided to let 3 inches of membrane hang down from the roof of the trailer. So I cut all the excess membrane off and kept it in case I ever need it for repairs. Now it was time to work on the trim and the door. So I took all the surplus aluminum that I had from my project and I brought it to Andrew at Windsor Metalworks. So Andrew helped me build the metal frame for Eddie in episode 4. So I was lucky enough to have just enough aluminum left over to have it bent for the door and all the trim that I would need to finish the outside of the trailer. Sometimes working alone, the biggest challenge is holding something in place while you're working on it. Putting the aluminum up on top of the trailer was going to be a challenge, so I came up with an idea. The 4-inch trim at the top of the trailer was mainly for aesthetics and to hold the 3 inches of overlapping rubber roof membrane in place. But I wanted the water to be able to run off of the rubber roof and not collect at the trim. So I put washers between the trim and the membrane. So there was a nice gap between the two so that if water pooled on top of the roof, it could run down between the trim and the rubber roof membrane. When I started this project, I had every intention of building my own door. I never wanted to feel like I was squeezing into my trailer, so I wanted one wide enough and tall enough for me, and also to be bringing gear in and out of the trailer. So I covered the ends of the 2x4s with aluminum in hopes of protecting them and also preventing any form of warping or twisting.
Thank you.
The small screws that came with the hinges were way too small to hold the door, and I was not confident that they would last the long term, so I decided to use long bolts and actually run them to the 2x4s and bolt them on the opposite side of the 2x4. This would ensure a very solid connection with the door and the framing. So now it's time to put a door handle on the door. Originally I thought I would install it traditionally, but dragging this through the bush I realized it would probably get caught on things eventually, so I decided to put it horizontally. Once the door was completed, I just had to finish up the last pieces of the trim on the front corners. And once the trim was in place, the exterior of the trailer was completely sealed. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, I'd really appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already done so, please subscribe for more videos. Episode 11 will be coming up shortly. Thanks. Cheers.